My name is Stanislav Horáček and I am from Czech LibreOffice community. I'm also a long-term member of the Document Foundation and I am dealing mainly with localization of LibreOffice to the Czech language. Today I will speak about spellcheck dictionaries and if everything goes well, my presentation follows after the speech of Marina Latini, which is a nice coincidence because it was her presentation at last year's LibreOffice conference, which inspires me to prepare this talk. She was talking about Italian community and about state that they had a spellcheck dictionary which has not been updated for a long time. And I recognized the same pattern at our Czech community, because our Handspell dictionary was created sometimes about 2005-6. It is a dictionary licensed under the GPL license, and it was a pity that it has not been updated for a really long time. I don't remember any significant update. That dictionary is used in most of free software applications and we experience that there are mistakes and there are also missing words because new words are being created. And just remember at all that electrobikes or smartphones, which we didn't have 15 years ago. But during the last years, three great things happened, and I will talk about them. Firstly, there was an update of that GPL dictionary. It was totally unexpected and it happened in this year. Also, a few years ago, a so-called Czech Morphological Dictionary was released under the CC0 license, which is Creative Commons Zero license, which means that we can use that data for whatever we want. It is totally permissive license. And also we have now a namespace with dictionary data at Wikidata, and they are also licensed under the CC0 license, so we decided to create a new dictionary with that license and provide it as an alternative of that GPL dictionary. And that GPL updated dictionary is now part of LibreOffice. I will talk about all three points, but mainly about the Wikidata dictionary data, so-called lexemes. Regarding the GPL dictionary update, it was a kind of miracle, because it was something what no one expected. The update was done by Miroslav Pošta, who is a translator, so a person who is really knows how to work with language, and he states that he wanted to do something useful during the corona times, and he indeed did, because he touched thousands of words. It was a huge effort. He corrected many forms or patterns for the words. He also systematically edit some parts. And he also removed some forms that are not so used, which sounds maybe a bit controversially, but this pragmatic approach makes sense for me. Just consider if we have a word and if it is more probable that that word is typo than if it is the rare form of valid word, then it makes sense to to mark it as incorrect. We somehow hit the limitations of Hanspell here, because Hanspell provides only binary spell check. For user it would be perfect to have some probability assigned to that check, but it is something what is not possible currently. And this updated dictionary is part of LibreOffice 7.2, and it is an advantage that LibreOffice is considered as upstream of Hanspell dictionaries, so it was taken also by Mozilla applications, and we are expecting that it will be taken by others. In 2019, Masaryk University, in cooperation with Red Hat, released their dictionary, which was based on analysis of language corpus and some semi-automatic processing of it. It contains only some selected parts of speech, namely nouns, adjectives, and verbs. There are also some missing parts, like proper nouns are missing, or comparison of adjectives is missing. But still, it is quite a sufficient database of tens of thousands lexemes, and it was used by us as a base for the new experimental dictionary. And the main point in 2018, Wikidata introduced a new namespace with a database of lexicographical data. The basic unit of that database is so-called lexeme, which can be typically a word, but also a phrase or a part of word, like suffix or prefix. And we can store also metadata there, like characteristics of the lexeme, relations with other lexemes, and so on. For Czech language, we have more than 2,000 lexemes there currently. And as we will see in a few moments, we have a user interface available to create and maintain lexemes, which allows to normal user access to that database. So important that it's a Wikimedia Foundation project, which guarantees stability, and it is better than any of homemade solutions which we were considering. And we are talking about spellcheck dictionaries, but it's a common database which we can use for any tool dealing with language, so also hyphenation dictionary, dictionary of synonyms, which we can both find in LibreOffice as well. But I can imagine also tools for adding diacritics to the text, dealing with translating or with grammar checking, and so on and so on. And we are doing here something what is a perfect example of free software or free data principles, because we are developing a common database shared by many projects and doing it at one place and by joint forces. How does it look? This is a page with example of lexeme, Czech adverb duchaplně. If you are familiar with Wikidata, you know that IDs of Wikidata items starts with Q. Here ID of lexeme starts with L. Here we have information about language, part of speech, and sense of the lexeme, and the list of forms follows. In this case we have 3 degrees of comparison of Czech adverbs. Another example is prasátko, which means a small pig. Here we have information about etymology, and then about language style, it's a diminutive. We can provide many types of language style, for instance, if it is formal or informal word, if it is archaic, if it is kind of dialect. And it's a bit pity that Handspell cannot work with this information, because for me as a user, I would love to check, I want to do my spell check only by using formal words, or I want also include informal words, and so on and so on. We can also connect lexemes with real Wikidata items, I mean that items starting with Q. So here we have three connected with the item, this is the link to the Wikidata item, and for instance we can then check the Wikipedia page about this term. Also we can state connections between lexemes. In this case we say that this lexeme has a synonym, and as I said before, this information can be directly used for creation of dictionary of synonyms. We can also add other metadata as pronunciation, examples of usage, and so on, but they are not usable by spellcheck dictionaries, so I will not talk about them. I was talking about a user interface for maintaining lexemes. This is a basic page how to create a new lexeme. I just insert lemma, basic forms, language and lexical category, which is part of speech, and I am done. Then I need to add all the forms of the lexeme by hand, which is not so convenient, so there are also templates provided. For instance, this template allows us to add all forms of a verb in this form. If we have more complicated cases, like in case of Czech adjective, which can have more than 100 of forms, we can use also this batch loading, and this input is prepared probably somehow automatically. Of course, we can use also API access to Wikidata, and specifically to Wikidata lexemes. There is a query language for Wikidata. We can use also Python packages for accessing the data. Like this one is a general one, and LexData is a package specialized for lexemes, but there are also others. A bit of statistics. Here we can see number of lexemes by language. We can find here big and traditional languages like Russian, English, German, French, but also a smaller one which has probably enthusiastic volunteers who enter the data. And in general, first places in these charts means that data has been imported automatically from some sources. But not only number of lexemes matters, this is a chart showing another aspect of the data. It means how much of Wikipedia texts are covered by that lexemes database. For instance, in case of Swedish, only about 10% of words in Wikipedia is not covered by a lexicographical database. And we are talking here about tokens, which means all words, not only unique words. So frequency of the words is considered in this matrix. This is something what I have already said, that we decided to create a new Czech spellcheck dictionary license under the CC0 license, which is created as a combination of morphological dictionary and of data from Wikidata, and that dictionary is still considered as experimental. It is provided as an extension for LibreOffice, and also Mozillians prepared version for the Mozilla applications, and we can also check words online at the web page českéslovníky.cz. Let's look how the old and new Czech dictionaries are successful. In this chart we see the similar characteristics as the coverage of Wikipedia was, with that difference that we don't have Wikipedia database here or Wikipedia corpus, but some small but still representative example of texts containing few hundred thousand of words. And in the chart we can again see the number of missing tokens, which are marked by the spell checked as incorrect. In the bottom part with red color we have that traditional GPL dictionary, which is shipped with LibreOffice, and this is the original former version, and there was also an alternative version which was not part of LibreOffice, but it was slightly better, and this one is the latest version, result of the update done by Miroslav Pošta, and we can see that his changes were really significant and improved the dictionary a lot. Regarding the new experimental CC0 dictionary, this is the initial state, which took only the data from the morphological dictionary with no Wikidata. If we include Wikidata, we see a significant improvement, and during the time as database on Wikidata was increasing, the improvement is more and more significant. So this is the current version, but we still see that the experimental dictionary is not at the same quality level as the original one. So the main message of my presentation is that we have a database of words or of lexemes at Wikidata. And its database for any language is licensed under the really, really permissive license. We can do whatever we want with that data. We can access it through quite convenient user interface or by programming interface. And the previous chart showed that we applied that data successfully to improve performance of spell checking dictionary of the Czech language. So if I could advise you, just check the lexemes and try to incorporate them into your spell checking dictionary, because it's available, it's for free, and you don't lose anything by testing it. And if you like it, you are welcome to contribute to that lexemes data. And in my opinion, the Wikidata lexemes, it's a perfect place where to store our dictionary data and where to maintain them. So that's all. Thanks for your attention, and let's go to the questions if there are any.